ALLSELECTED is likely to be the most complex DAX function of the entire DAX language. That is why we are not going to provide a full description of what it does. Instead, specifically for ALLSELECTED, we will focus on the use cases of ALLSELECTED, understanding when to use it, and understanding how to use it safely, without incurring in the dangers which are very well hidden in ALLSELECTED. Let's start by understanding when to use it. Look at the report we have on the screen. I am slicing by brand, the sales amount, and I am computing the percentage, which is the division of sales amount divided by the grand total of sales amount. The calculation is already there, and it's a division of sales amount by calculate sales amount, and I'm using all product to get rid of the filter from the product table and retrieve the grand total. Everything is working fine, but I might be in trouble, or at least I might obtain inaccurate results if I start using a slicer. Focus on the value 685, which is the value of the percentage of a datum against the grand total. If I use the slicer to filter some of the brands, you see that the value for a datum did not change. It is still 685, and the grand total does not show 100%. That is accurate, because what I'm doing here is I'm using all to get rid of any filter on the brand. By removing any filter, I remove both the filter which is coming from the current visual, but also the filter which is coming from the outside slicer. If this is not what I want, if I want to get rid of the filter from the current visual, but still keep the outer filter, the one coming from the slicer, then what I can do is use ALLSELECTED instead of all. By using ALLSELECTED, now this calculator will remove the filter coming from the brand, but will keep the filter coming from the outside slicer. And if I hit enter, now you see that the value for a datum changes, because now it's 2 millions divided by 17 millions, no longer 30 millions. So this is the main use case of ALLSELECTED. Let's now take a look in more detail at the usage you can do with ALLSELECTED. The percentage we computed is sales amount divided by calculate sales amount with ALLSELECTED product. ALLSELECTED has all the functions of the entire ALL family of functions, can be used both as a calculate modifier or as a table function, even though it is most likely to be used as a calculate modifier. And this is what we have done in the formula. ALLSELECTED can be used with a table and can also be used with an individual column or with no argument at all, as we can do with remove filters or with all. With one column, it restores the outer filter context on one column only. Without arguments, it restores the outer filter context on the entire data model. Speaking about ALLSELECTED, we say that it can be used both as a calculate modifier or as a table function. If you use it as a table function, it retrieves the ALLSELECTED product, that is, the product as they were visible in the outer filter context. Here, we filter by category, and so the results are all the product, the count of all the products in the category audio. I said in the introduction that ALLSELECTED is actually much more complex than it looks at first sight. Indeed, ALLSELECTED works by using shadow filter context and actually retrieving the list of values of a column that is currently being iterated. Its behavior is very complex, and if you are interested in all the details, you can go at this link, and there you will find a very long article that describes at a very high level of detail all the information about ALLSELECTED. But this is just to give you an idea of what ALLSELECTED does. In this code, I have addColumns, which is an iterator, which is running inside CalculateTable. CalculateTable places a filter for the category to be audio or computer. So the filter context under which addColumns runs, the outer filter context of addColumns, is audio and computer. And then it iterates over all product category, all ignores the filter context, it is used as a table function here, and we compute the sales amount and the sales amount using ALLSELECTED over product category. Now, common sense would say that this ALLSELECTED restores the filter context which was coming from outside. But this is not what is happening. ALLSELECTED actually does not access to this filter context. Instead, it restores the filter context which is currently being iterated, that is all product category. If we run the query and we increase the font a bit, you see that the sales amount of audio is the value of sales amount of audio, but sales cell is not the sum of audio and computers. That would be around 7 million. Instead, is 30 million. That is the grand total of all sales, because the filter context restored by ALLSELECTED is the one iterated by AddColumns. And this is the reason why it is extremely dangerous to use ALLSELECTED if you are inside an iterator or if any kind of iteration happen outside of your code. If your code is running inside the iteration created by Power BI in order to build the visual, then ALLSELECTED does exactly what you would expect from it. But if you start iterations before ALLSELECTED, then the behavior is correct, but extremely hard to understand. So this leads us to the rules to use ALLSELECTED. It is safe to use ALLSELECTED as one of the arguments of calculate. It is kind of dangerous using ALLSELECTED as a table function, because even though it works and it does exactly what it is expected to do, understanding this semantic is kind of hard. Another important detail is that you can use ALLSELECTED if it is a calculate modifier used very early in the measure definition. If you have calculate whatever you want using ALLSELECTED, that is good, it's safe, and you can rely on its behavior. If you do calculate some x over product and then another calculate and inside that you put ALLSELECTED, then you just went too far. So ALLSELECTED is nested deep inside your measure and its behavior becomes really hard to understand and follow. And as a rule of thumb, never use ALLSELECTED inside an iteration, as we did in the previous example. Because if you use ALLSELECTED inside an iteration, the filter context you retrieve is not the outer filter context, but it is the filter context defined by the whole iteration.